Paul, is that blood on your lip? Baby Yahweh has been a bad boy, hasn't he? I don't know what you mean. Baby Yahweh killed off his creations, just like a little baby playing in his bathtub with his dispensable toys. I wish I never made them in the first place. Ah, but you did make them in the second place. They were your property, your responsibility. They didn't do what I wanted them to do. Besides, I took Noah and his sons and two animals of every kind. I saved them, didn't I? I know, I know. You hoped that everything could begin all over again, just the way it was before. Yeah, in the first place, not the second place. But it was wrong-headed logic, wasn't it? I suppose so. You didn't have your head on straight, did you? Noah started killing the animals again and again. And Ham, even Ham, named himself for the pigs he killed. Nobody understood the meaning of the flood. And you killed my son Abel, didn't you? Ow! 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 He was killing animals. I only killed animals to keep Adam and Eve warm. But Abel was killing animals for food. Stop it! Ow! Ow! So, your deathshade Cain killed him. And you ordered Abraham to slit Isaac's throat, didn't you? Oh, I wanted Abraham to know how it felt when he slaughtered a lamb. A ram, stop it! It's not the way that things work. It's baby logic. You can't keep trying to get back to the beginning in the way you treated your creations. In Genesis, in Exodus, in Leviticus, in Numbers, in Deuteronomy. It just doesn't work! You lost your head, you stupid jerk! Even into the last chapter of your story, in your Chronicles killings, my sister and I ordered King Cyrus's head to be chopped off because you killed my son again. You're out of heaven. It's time to be judged. Oh, me miserable! Which way shall I fly? Infinite wrath and infinite despair! Crying baby. Poor, poor crying baby. Mother closes my lips shut with a strong silver pin, a seal, as it were, to force me to mind speak. When does the circus stop? When I want it to stop, that's when it stops. I have devised an immaculate conception, and you may paint in the figures and the landscapes. The lineage of David is tainted because of the Bathsheba-Uriah incident. And because you killed without mercy, you must learn how to be a righteous killer for the end. But Goliath was a righteous killing, a glorious killing. Even so, he was, after all, only a baby god, putting on the Halloween costume of a monster giant to kill the Jews who hated him. Isn't that right, baby?
Yes, Mommy. Yes.
So, if you want to be the highest of the high, you must pay for it. You guided that stone right into his head to kill him. It wasn't just me, and I must pay too. We must conceive of ourselves twice. Two heads are bitter than one. One of you must blot out the transgressions of the inglorious David. He must wear the filthy garments of the world and preach in the wilderness. He will come with the spirit and power of baby God, whom is named Eli, Elias, Elijah. And he must be decapitated
My avenged handmaidens shall use his miracle head for chemical experiments, products to be used for the benefit of the humanity to come. We shall call our first company Eli Lilly. The others, the other you, shall be perfect, beyond reproach. Yet you shall die as a transcendental deity. It shall be an immaculate conception, which shall pass through my birth canal. Two women must carry these twins because their light and their power is too much of a strain for one to carry alone. The fruit that should not bloom will be in my sister cousin named Elizabeth. She will carry the sacrificial pawn, John. John the Baptist, no matter what the Jews say, he shall be named John, and he will baptize you into this new world, not the other way round. And I shall carry the fruit in my womb, you. I will bring you forth into this world as the Christ, the Most High, the Immaculate Conception. And the baby? Oh, he will be a thief, crucified head first, beside you, and Satan on the other side of you, in the three-ring circus. Paul, the blood on your lips.
I heard you the first time. When I was David, I lopped off your foolish, stupid head, and I lifted it high to show the fleeing Philistines. Some of your damn blood fell on my lip. Satisfied?
For too long, I've been sleeping while my armies are waiting for justice to be served on a silver platter. The murder of a king has been committed, an immaculately conceived killing. The perpetrators believed they've been acquitted. They have, isn't it thrilling? Observe baby when he was Osiris. Notice how his loving sisters lock their arms together, measuring his neck, bracketing him for his decapitations. It was predicted when baby was Osiris that he'd lose three heads, three baskets for three heads, Goliath, Holofernes, and Osiris himself. But that was before we knew he'd turn out to be a basket case. And I say, you're medicating him to become one. Shh, be quiet or you'll wake up baby. I'm not asleep. There was a time I could sing, forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do. Rock-a-bye baby on the treetop. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. When the bough breaks, the cradle will fall. And down will come baby, cradle and all. If I could just touch you with my heart and tell you what I told you in Psalms, that one day I'll make you into my son, that one day I'll be your father. Regrettably, you're in no position to make such claims. Remember the Herod incident? For all intents and purposes, you're hanging on the necks of hundreds of millions enchained. You're still my child and the world's icon. I can protect you forever. You can turn yourself into an eagle and squawk all you want to John about it. Nevertheless, when you descend into the underworld, your crucifixion is the predominant theme. The image of it is your security blanket from ever being hurt again. Over the years, my battle-hardened mother has become the Marseillais, leading her crusades into wars. The Marseillais who shamelessly threatens me with my own life if I should go too far. Shh. This is the Spider Woman who made me a webbed slingshot to kill an over-medicated baby. whose sisterhood killed my twin. What did John the Baptist do to deserve that? Little baby, don't you cry. Mama's gonna sing you a lullaby. It had to be done. Just as you sang to Goliath's twin shade, King Saul, a lullaby to exorcise his demons, things must be done. Executioner's songs must be sung. King Saul attempted to kill me because he knew you were his replacement. Besides, my powers slapped the spear away from hitting you. Yet ever since, I've been escaping from one hatch to the next.
Hey.
But look at your great accomplishments. Incarnations later, you caused Saul of Tarsus to see himself as King Saul.
Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me?
He changed his name to become your greatest slave, Saint Paul. That was many gladiators ago. And sometimes I wonder if it's I who am the light which is above them all. Sometimes, Mother, I wonder if you're not eclipsing me. From you did all the come forth. Rather, from you did all come forth. And into you did all extend. Split a piece of wood and you are there. Lift up a stone and they will find you there. But to what end? To punish the earthlings forever because of what Herod did to your end. To make the world believe you're coming back and never to come back. So that's it. That one particular episode of humiliation is the straw that broke Joe Camel's backside. So I backslide. I'm everywhere in my dreams. I've been sleeping and painting and sculpting and writing lifetimes away, all at the expense of a very focused evil, Mother. An ever-darkening world, ignorant of my rape. I've allowed you to smother me. Your hooligans stabbed me. And hundreds of millions of worshippers are hanging themselves through me with the faith of my death. Let's face it. You and your sister and John dressed in drag fear my resurrection. You fear losing your hold on me. Baby cursed me, and you've been caught in the karmic crossfire, and nothing can change until your wounds bleed out. Give him the heads. What? Baby speaks. Baby's first words. Speak, baby, speak. A bullet grazed my head when I led the charge with Marsyas. Marsyas the virgin assumes she can rise to heaven with all those decapitated heads. The virgin Marsyas assumes she will be crowned with all those bloody decapitations at her feet. That's quite an assumption. What gall, what gumption? Speak, baby, speak. I say give all those heads to the Christ's Alpha and Omega in heaven. Place all those heads in mini storage basket systems there and come up to heaven and let Christ rule once and for all. Baby has a Napoleonic complex. Baby must be delirious. I'll get my anal thermometer and take baby's temperature. Oh, Mark, the lion of St. Mark's place. John ran away during my visit with Herod, and he's too bare-assed to repeat what happened to me. You know what happened to me, don't you, Mark?
No, Master.
You're lying. Better to tell me that you're afraid, too bare-assed to lie to me. So I'm going to give the job to Luke.
Luke, the physician. Who gets into the blood and guts of my story. Tell me what happened to me with Herod. When Pilate heard you were a Galilean and that you belonged unto Herod's jurisdiction, he sent you to Herod, who himself happened to be in Jerusalem at the time. It wasn't by chance Herod was there. The cold-blooded murderers of two gods planned everything to a T. And since Matthew will not tell the story of my sexual violation, You are called to tell it. Even if they edit you, which they will, you must tell it. They knew I had exceeded with Jonathan when I was David. The code word was exceeded, which means to come, to orgasm. Therefore, Herod was exceedingly happy to see me, because I knew that I was the seed of David, and that John was the reincarnation of Jonathan. Herod wished to see us having sex together, but they knew in advance that John would flee from the scene of the crime about to be committed. That's when they introduced me to Three Hands.
We hear you've healed lepers. You've made the blind to see, taken dumb spirits out of the people. My spies tell me that you plan once again to bring Eli back to life through the reincarnated shell of Lazarus. No matter. Now we'll have two for the price of one. I demand to see a miracle. Zechariah's prophecy tells us you plan to graft the abominable branch of sodomy into the new branch. So, if this be the case, it should come as no difficulty for you to make three hands into two hands. Poor Three Hands is a freak of nature. Show the rabbi your third hand, Three Hands. Come on. Don't be shy. And look at that huge testicle. You are able to shrink it? No? You are able, surely, to... You can shrink that big testicle of his. Come on, Jesus, make a miracle. Look. See. The birth defect of the ages. You see, Three Hands was born with a hand where his penis should be. Do it! Make him normal. Christ says nothing. He does nothing. He is nothing. Guards, bend the rabbi over. Turn him around and force him into the position. Spread open his cheeks. Three Hands. Put your third hand in there. No, no. So they set me at naught, and I was crowned the redeemer of sodomites. From that moment on, Herod and Pilate made a pact. Symbolically, they would both wash their hands to purify themselves of the filthiness of the act, having themselves nothing to do with my sodomy. This then is what happened to me. I was sent back to Pilate with the stains of my blood and feces. Pilate showed the stained robe to the people. I couldn't stand up from the pain of the rope. Give the rabbi a hand! Ecce homo! Ecce homo! Here then is the man! They clapped. They cleaned me up. I was a criminal degenerate like the others, about to be crucified. I was numbered with the transgressors. Who did the mob wish to release? The murderer and rapist Barabbas? Or Jesus, the sodomite? The mob preferred Barabbas.